Well, hello. God bless you, Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here. Caught me getting a little sip of my coffee here today. You know, the weather's changing a little bit in North Carolina and getting a little nip out there. But I tell you what, I'm grateful to be saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. And I'm excited about tonight. And I must admit, listen, it's going to be just us tonight. As you know, last week we had a tremendous women's weekend. And I'll tell you, God blessed in a mighty way. And I'm still saying to my lovely wife, Pamela, congratulations. She spearheaded that event. And it was just great. I thank God for the members of the Upper Room Church of God in Christ, our women's department, our men's department, our youth department. I mean, listen, our music department, and the saints were fantastic. And to all of the members of the Upper Room and for all of you who came from near and far, thank you for being a part of the tremendous Women's Weekend. We're grateful to God for all of our guests who ministered during that week. I tell you, we had some of the most powerful women in Christendom ministering the word of the Lord, and it was just great. And I'm still thanking the Lord. We enjoyed Evangelist Kennedy. God used her in a mighty way. Prophetess Janet Floyd during the weekend, God used her in a mighty way. My wife doing the Saturday day sessions as she continued the Women's Talk Live. You know, just so many things. Well, if I start calling names, I'm going to omit someone, but it was great. And they allowed yours truly to minister on Thursday night in the meeting, and I'm honored that they would allow me to be a part of the weekend, and God has blessed us in a mighty way. Now, tonight, we're going back to our regular scheduled program where we're going to walk in the scriptures. I'm excited about it. You know, in times like these, I am glad. I thank God for the Bible. My friends, have you ever seen a day quite like today? We're praying for our nation from the White House to the outhouse. We need prayer. We need prayer. We need prayer. We need revival. We need hearts and minds changed. We need God to move on us. We need God to move in our morals, to move in our thinking. And I want you to know, I'm praying for your mind. I'm praying for your mind. I'm praying for your mind. I'm praying for your spirit, that Satan not, that the devil not wear you out. It is the will of Satan to try to get you to implode with overload. It's always something coming. You know, in the kingdom of God, battles don't come and go. Battles just come. They come. They mount up. They mount up. If it's not this, it's that. If it's not that, it's this. If it's not this, it's the other, and so forth and so on. But let me tell you something. We serve a God who is able to anoint us to handle all of these things and to keep us from fainting or growing weary in our minds. He's a God who revives, and he'll set your soul on fire. And tonight we're going to be talking about it. And I'm excited about the opportunity to share the word of the Lord with you. I thank you so much for your faithfulness. I thank God for those who are going to join me live in the sanctuary, and for those who tune in through social media, through this medium. God bless every one of you. Many of you from where you are, you can't be here, but you're here. You're praying for us. You're watching. And we thank the Lord for you, for our television audience, our radio audience, all of those. I just feel, Brother Gary, thankful to the people for their support. There is a powerful market for God's truth. And I want to tell you about a presentation. I've got two big ones that we're getting ready to put together. And I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep it to myself just for a little while longer, but you keep watching, because I'm telling you, the truth of God will forever stand. And when truth is on your side, you don't have to be apologetic. You don't have to clear your throats. You don't have to search for words. The truth lays it all out there. And the wonderful thing about the truth is our Lord said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Glory to God. Make you free. Being made free is better than being set free. For many have been set free, but the recidivism rate is real high. They end up going right back in. But when you've been made free, that means you're free in your heart. You're free in your soul. You're free in your mind. You're free. It's no longer a part of you. And you can live and walk in the freedom of God. There are many who are behind prison walls, and I'm leaving, but I'm speaking to you today. You're locked up. You're there in most cases because of crimes you committed. And there are innocent people who have been convicted also. But many of you have met Jesus Christ. And even though you're in confinement, you're yet free. Because Jesus knows how to touch you right where you are. And yet there are people who are watching, who are walking the streets every day. You can go where you want to go. You can do what you want to do. And you're bound on the inside. Some of you don't want to live. I want to say to you, life is still worth living. Don't take your life. You know, suicide is up. Alcoholism is up. Many things are up. For one reason, we had governors who thought that churches were non-essential. Well, I tell you what, that proved to be wrong, didn't it? People need the house of God, and people need the word of God. And if you're watching today and you're despondent and you're down and you feel rejected and the enemy is trying to rob you of your hope, I want to say to you, keep living. Stay with the Lord. Grab hold to Jesus' hand. I feel I'm talking to someone. Grab hold to Jesus' hand, because the Lord is going to allow the sun to shine again in your life. Well, meet me tonight right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ for Bible study. Yes, you guessed it, Bible study. Tonight, we are going to study the Word of the Lord together. I'll see you tonight right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ.